One day I was walking home from grocery shopping with heaps of heavy bags, and so I decided to give some thought to which way home would be the shortest. Well, the shortest route would definitely have been the straight diagonal path from the shops to my house, but unfortunately no one had made that path for me. Instead, there were only paths that went north-south and east-west. Surely some of these paths are better than others, I reasoned, because the diagonal line is the best. So routes which are almost diagonal should be better than going all the way around, right? At this point, my brain started to hurt, so I forgot all about this and just trudged back home the regular way. When I got home, though, I got interested in this question again, but I decided to make the problem a bit simpler. I want to find the shortest path between this corner and this corner of the square, but no diagonals are allowed, and the path can only go left or up. This is the longest path, and it's 2 units long. The would-be shortest path is the diagonal, which, by trusty Pythagoras, is root 2 units long. Let's draw some other random path. What's the total distance in the left direction? Well, I guess it's 1 unit. And the distance in the up direction is 1 unit also, making the total distance 2, just like the long way around. The same thing is true for all paths. I was completely wrong. There is no shortest path, because all the paths have exactly the same length. To you, this is probably like, yeah, obviously. For me, this is still so surprising. Let me explain. The diagonal is the shortest route, but we can draw one of our allowed paths that approximate it. You might not think that this is a particularly good approximation, but I can make it better and better and better until your eyes can't even tell the difference. In fact, I could make the approximation so good, someone walking on it probably couldn't even tell that they're not quite walking in a straight line. But then, they have to be able to tell, because no matter how great the approximation is, these paths all have length 2, which is way longer than root 2. So this way, they'll end up walking so much extra distance than if they were actually on the diagonal. See, that's the bit that really messes with my head. Another weird bit is that in some ways, the sequence is a good approximation for the line. If you know calculus, or if you've seen my last episode, you know that if what we cared about was the area underneath the diagonal instead of the diagonal's length, this staircase shape has area that gets closer and closer to the area we want. So we have this sequence of shapes that visually approximate the line very well, and we know it approximates the area very well too. And yet it's terrible at approximating the line's length. This is a really worrying example. How do we know in advance when an approximation is not going to be good enough? I really don't know. So even though we all use approximations a lot without a second thought, even approximations that look like they're really good can go completely wrong. Well, there are lots of places we can go from here, because this whole thing brings up heaps of questions. One bit I'm really interested in is the fact that the shape we were talking about is actually a fractal. Fractals in general are kind of the arch nemesis of calculus, so we might take up the story from there next time. See you then!